Well, I think what really surprised me about the script was that personal story underneath. You know, you expect a movie like this to have the set pieces and the bells and whistles and to be a thrill ride and all of those things. But for me, you know, the thing that gets me excited about telling a story is like what's happening underneath it. And I realized, wow, this is a movie about like an introverted, sarcastic person that I somehow can relate to. I don't know why. Sort of learning to feel his feelings.
Well, hi, I'm Jared Alexander with theGrio.
Hey, good
First
to be
off,
here.
hi, good to see you. And first off, congratulations. I mean, I just thought this movie was so much fun, A, but I kind of wanted to start a little bit with your history with the ride.
Sure.
As I understand, you were a cast member even at Disneyland. So just talk to me a little bit about, you know, this opportunity coming about and just, yeah, your own personal connections to this story.
Honestly, it goes even back further than that. I went to Disney World for the first time because my mother saved up the money and took us to Disney World in Orlando, Florida, when I was like 9 or 10. And that was the first time I encountered the Haunted Mansion. And I grew up, I was a Disney kid, man. I watched these movies and these sort of four quadrant big family movies, but they sort of always worked even as I got older. And they always kind of left me with a little something sticky extra to say, you know, but they were also really entertaining. That stuff was just kind of in my blood a little bit. And I went to film school at a place called Chapman University. It's in Orange County. And in terms of like summer jobs, it was like, you know, I could work at Tuesday morning or I could work at Disneyland. So I picked Disneyland, and I got my whole life because like I was a film student, you know, studying film. But then at Disneyland, there was this whole other education about storytelling because I realized like, oh wow, like I actually get goosebumps at the same point on all of these rides, and I'm being immersed in a kind of story that works like clockwork. And I never, honestly, never even imagined that I would have an opportunity to do something like this. But when it came along, it just really felt right. It felt like it was something that was for me and that I was prepared to do.
Absolutely. I mean, even you saying that now makes me just think of the movie, like in at like Haunted Mansion, for example, or any Disney ride, the queue, like you're immersed from the beginning, and the movie feels similar. Like we don't get the credits when people see it for a while. You know, you're kind of being immersed in the story from the beginning, which I just think that that's so cool too. And I was thinking too just about the differences between, let's say, like a horror story and a ghost story. And I feel like ghost stories, to me, at their core, are love stories, right? You know, being haunted, having lost, you know what I mean? All those things. And I loved that this really weaved that into it as well. Like you said, it could be a family movie, but it's leaving you with something sticky. So talk to me too just about the story and you know, being able to tell it in that way. Of course, there are jump scares and amazing fun effects, but I think the undercurrent is really powerful too.
Well, I think what really surprised me about the script was that personal story underneath. You know, you expect a movie like this to have the set pieces and the bells and whistles and to be a thrill ride and all of those things. But for me, you know, the thing that gets me excited about telling a story is like what's happening underneath it. And I realized, wow, this is a movie about like an introverted, sarcastic person that I somehow can relate to. I don't know why. Sort of learning to feel his feelings. And that's, I thought, was such a sweet thing for a movie to even say. And that sort of helps kids like lean into the things that scare them and to know that, like, you know what? It is scary. You might laugh while it's happening, but you'll get to the other side. And I just felt like honestly, that was a story I needed to be told when I came across the script, and I felt like others would want it too. And everything else has to hang on that core story for me. And I just felt like it was a strong one. So that's what we went with.
Yeah, absolutely. And I think there are different entry points too with that. I mean, of course, you have Lakeith's character as the main character, but a lot of them are also struggling with their own feelings in similar ways. And I was so taken aback too with just how much of a fun ensemble piece it is. Like I grew up, like I'm such a big like Scooby-Doo person. And it just kind of had that vibe of like, you know, this team is coming together to figure this supernatural stuff out. So talk to me about that too, and being able to work with actors like this in an ensemble piece, really. I mean, so much of it, the dynamics were so fun to see them once they're all together.
Well, I always love ensemble movies. I mean, my first movie is an ensemble movie. My series is very ensemble driven. And so when I got the script, I was like, okay, I know how to do a comedy ensemble. Like I actually know how to put those pieces together. It's so much about the casting, and it's about sort of creating these dynamics that can kind of live and breathe and sort of create moments that go above and beyond even what's just there on the page. It's all about getting the right people together and creating the right environment for them to kind of like slam off of each other and work off of each other. And I was so lucky to, you know, have the access to a cast like this. And everybody was just firing on all cylinders, and everybody knew exactly what their notes were and what they were really good at. And at that point, it was just about encouraging everyone to bring themselves to the role, to sort of take us, you know, obviously, okay, we got a priest. It's not really a priest. That's spoiler alert. We got a, you know, a paranormal photographer who's given up. We have those basic things, but now take me in a direction I won't expect with these characters. And let's kind of go against type where we can. And everyone had a lot of fun doing that. And I think it shows.
Of course, I know you shot a little bit in New Orleans as well. I've already feel like I've been like encountering some weird. I'm like, ooh, that was kind of weird. What's your relationship just with like ghost things in general? And while you were here, was there any freaky things that happened?
I'm a believer, man. I really am. And I, you know, my family's from Louisiana. We sort of grew up in that weird, like post-Catholic, post-voodoo kind of world. So I'm already on the frequency of all this kind of stuff. I really am. And I just embraced it and really tried to create an environment where the cast felt like they could embrace it too. I got everybody big, giant, ridiculous crystals and different things to burn. And, you know, I like tried my hand at different kind of like, you know, mantras and the tarot and all that stuff. And I don't know. Hopefully by osmosis, it just all kind of made its way into the movie.
Yes. You, of course, are like a fan of like fantasy horror or like just like fantasy fun movies. What are some that you felt like left an impact to you, kind of going back to when we were first talking, growing up and being raised by those movies, be it Disney or any other movie, like things that kind of left those imprints?
Well, I mean, I think about Little Shop of Horrors. You know, which is one of my absolute favorites. I think about Return to Oz. Mm-hmm. I think about Ghost.
That's a scary one.
That's a scary, very scary.
That leads on to scary.
Yeah, that movie is legitimately scary. Mm-hmm. The first movie I ever, speaking of legitimately, first movie I ever remember seeing is The Wiz, which I think actually is also that, especially when you get into the subway.
Yes.
And that just sort of mix of absolutely unrealistic with totally real. Mm-hmm. I don't know, but I just sort of, I always gravitated to those kind of movies, so I paid homage as best I could to them.
Yeah.
And Clue, I can't forget Clue.
Of course.
Clue is like the ultimate ensemble comedy mystery thriller movie, so that was a big inspiration as well.